then Allah will take care of them. The best we start our conference Quran recitation by Imam Abdullah D from Orlando, Florida. فليتفضل مشكورا مجموعا.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الذين يبلغون رسالات الله ويخشونه ولا يخشون أحدا إلا الله وكفى بالله حسيبا. الذين يبلغون رسالات الله ويخشونه ولا يخشون أحدا وكفى بالله حسيبا. ما كان محمد أبا ولكن رسول الله وخاتم النبيين وكان الله بكل شيء عليما. وكان الله بكل شيء عليما. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اذكروا الله ذكرا كثيرا وسبحوه بكرة وأصيلا.
This is not the first one, but it's one of the best hosts we ever had. ICCI, with the leadership of Imam Sheikh Amin Al-Ali, our host, they did everything possible to make your conference as successful as we can. So all what we can say for them, Jazakumullahu anna kulla khair. Now we want to listen for our host 5 minutes talk, inshallah.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على أشرف مبعوث لخلق الله سيدنا محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وعلى آله وصحبه ومن والاه. ابتداء إخوتي وأحبتي أحبكم جميعا بهذا التجمع المبارك. التجمع الذي يسعى إلى النهوض بهذه الأمة أمة محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم. وابتداء أنا شاكر لأخي الدكتور عمر والإخوة الأعضاء في تجمع الأئمة على استجابتهم لدعوتنا وحضورهم إلى شيكاغو. ابتداء أقول لكم أن الجو اليوم دافئ. يعني enjoy the weather. لكن مقارنة مع الأسابيع الماضية كان الجو باردا جدا. اليوم الحمد مقارنة مع الحمد لله يقارن. فهذه بداية لطيفة. أنا قلت للإخوة في المسجد اليوم أنه هذا ببركة المشايخ ما شاء الله ارتفعت درجة الحرارة. راح تصل إن شاء الله إلى 45 وحرارة الإيمان إن شاء الله يضخ علينا شوي منها. هذه نقطة. النقطة الثانية إخوتي وأحبتي, حقيقة كان السنة الماضية اقتراح عند الدكتور عمر أنه نجعل هذا المؤتمر في شيكاغو. حبت أن نكون كل سنة في مكان حتى أنه ننهض بالجالية ككل في كل أمريكا, وإن شاء الله سيكون المرة القادمة إما في فلوريدا أو في كاليفورنيا على ما تحدث أنا أخي الدكتور عمر. النهوض بالأمة يا إخوة يحتاج إلى ناهضين. فاقد الشيء كما في القواعد الشرعية, فاقد الشيء لا يعطيه. إذا كان الأئمة خوامل ستكون أمة خاملة, سيكون مجتمع خامل. كما أن الإنسان في خاصة في هذه الأيام مع هذا التطور الفقهي الرهيب الذي نعيشه وممتد ويسير بتسارع شديد, أنه كثير للأسف من مشايخنا من أحبتنا لا زالوا في عالم آخر, وهذا لن ينهض بالأمة. لابد أن نواكب العصر, لابد أن نعيش الحياة التي نعيشها بالواقع الذي نعيش. لا بأس أن نستسقي وأن نستخلص الفقه السابق, فقه الأولين, وأن نستفيد منه وأن نعيش فيه, لكن أن نطور كذلك من حياتنا. هذا الدين لو جمد أو لو جمد الفقه في هذا الدين في زمن من الأزمنة كما تعلمون جميعا, وإنما أنا مذكر, لجمد هذا الدين. لكن الله سبحانه وتعالى من رحمته أن أراد هذا الدين أن يكون إلى يوم الدين. فإذا جمدنا في مكان جمد معنا, ونحن في هذا البلد بالذات مطالبون أن ننهض بأبنائنا التحدي الأكبر, أن ننهض بعائلاتنا التحدي الذي يليه, ثم النهوض بأنفسنا. بعض الأئمة يعيش 10 أو 15 سنة في أمريكا لا يتطور ولا يتقدم خطوة للأمام, وبعضهم ما شاء الله يتقدمون يتطورون ينجزون ويجتهدون, وكل هذا من أجل النهوض بالجالية ممن حولنا. والناس جميعا يا إخوة أبشركم, الناس جميعا ينظرون إليكم نظرة إجلال وتقدير, وينظرون ويتوقعون من خلالكم أن يكون التغيير, أن يكون التحول مما عليه هذه الأمة في هذه الأيام الصعيبة والتي يعني يعاني منها كثير من المسلمين في كثير من الأماكن. الحقيقة سنتكلم في هذا إن شاء الله في مستقبل هذا اليوم ومستقبل يوم غد إن شاء الله, وسيطرح في مجالات متطورة أو متعددة إن شاء الله. أسأل الله سبحانه وتعالى أن يجعل هذا الاجتماع اجتماعا مرحوما, وأن يرزقنا فيه الإخلاص في القول والعمل. وصل اللهم على محمد وآله وصحبه وسلم.
جزاك الله خير. May Allah reward you. بارك الله فيكم. جئتم أهلا وحللتم سهلا في شيكاغو. عندنا حرارة الإيمان وعندهم برضو اليقين ما شاء الله. نسأل الله أن يجمع هذا بذاك. وقد اجتمعا من أريزونا ومن تكساس, احنا جئنا هنا بهالبرد. الحمد لله رب العالمين. Dear respected imams, unfortunately our chairman Dr. Waleed Al-Manisi, إن شاء الله خير بإذن الله تعالى. Ask Allah سبحانه وتعالى that everything is okay, but he did not show up for reason or another. For this, inshallah ta'ala, our vice chairman, Dr. Bassam Obeid, will talk in Naif Board of Trustees' behalf. فليتفضل مشكورا مأجورا جزاه الله عنا كله. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi ta'ala wa barakatuh. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reward all of you. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala put all your effort in your scales on the Day of Judgment, inshallah. I wish the best for our chairman, Dr. Waleed, in his trip, inshallah ta'ala. On his behalf, inshallah, I'd like to recite what he wrote.
in the front of you. Jazakumullahu khairan. Bismillah, wa salatu wa salamu ala Sayyidina Muhammadin Rasulillah, wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa muhtada bihudah. فإن المؤتمر السنوي لاتحاد الأئمة بأمريكا الشمالية لهذا العام ينعقد بمشيئة الله بمدينة شيكاغو في شهر المحرم 1436 للهجرة الموافق شهر نوفمبر 2014 من الميلاد، حيث كان وما زال هذا العام حافلا بأحداث جسام تموج بها الأمة الإسلامية، حيث جراح المسلمين نازفة في فلسطين وسوريا والعراق ومصر واليمن وبورما وغيرها من أقطار المسلمين. والمسلمون بالولايات المتحدة وإن كانت أجسادهم هنا فأرواحهم ممتزجة بأرواح إخوانهم في مشارق الأرض ومغاربها، يتألمون لألمهم ويفرحون لفرحهم مصداقا لما جاء في الصحيحين من حديث النعمان بن البشير رضي الله تعالى عنهما قال: قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم: مثل المؤمنين في توادهم وتراحمهم وتعاطفهم مثل الجسد الواحد، أو مثل الجسد إذا اشتكى منه عضو تداعى له سائر الجسد بالسهر والحمى. وقد كان لما تمر به الأمة الإسلامية من أحداث أثر بالغ على أحوال المسلمين المقيمين بالولايات المتحدة، مما جعل من المناسب أن يكون عنوان مؤتمرنا السنوي دور الأئمة في نهوض الأمة. والمراد هنا هو دور كل إمام في النهوض بأمته الخاصة، وهي أهل حيه ومدينته، ثم بعد ذلك كيف يجعل من أمته الخاصة الصغيرة لبنة صالحة في بنيان الأمة العامة الكبيرة، أمة الإجابة التي استجابت لدعوة نبينا محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وأسلموا معه لله رب العالمين، والتي هي جزء من أمة الدعوة وهي جميع الثقلين. وحيث إن الأحداث الجسام التي تمر بها الأمة الإسلامية قد أثارت نقاشات وحوارات بين المسلمين في الولايات المتحدة، تطورت في أحيان كثيرة إلى خصومات ونزاعات، فقد كان لزاما على الأمة أن يرشدوا مجتمعاتهم إلى كيفية التوفيق بين قيم إنكار المنكر ونصرة المظلوم والصدع للحق من جهة، وقيم الحكمة في الدعوة وتأليف القلوب والحفاظ على أرواح المسلمين ودمائهم من جهة أخرى. نسأل الله تعالى أن يعين الأمة على النهوض بالأمة والأخذ بيدها إلى بر النجاة. وبالله التوفيق. دكتور وليد بن إدريس المنيسي، رئيس مجلس أمناء اتحاد الأئمة بأمريكا، وجزاكم الله خيرا. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله.
بارك الله فيك، جزاكم الله كل خير. نسأل الله أن يكون سبب التأثير خيرا بإذن الله تعالى لفضيلتي. إخواني، كلمة الإكزيكتيف كوميتي يعني، ومن بعدها يتسلم المهام الرئيسية as MC our شيخ هير إمام our host شيخ أمين العلي إن شاء الله. إخواني، بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. أنا ما عندي I don't have anything to say. All what I want to say, believe it or not, together we can make it better. Together we can make it better. One humble advice from your brother, don't underestimate, Sheikh Marwan, don't underestimate yourself. Imam can do miracles and can motivate the whole community. Imam can do a lot. Bring more unity to the community, more tranquility to the community. In the other hand, Imam can do disaster situation. So never ever underestimate what you can do. I know some Imams, mashallah, they changed the whole community.
they motivate the whole community. And they did a big project. People scared even to talk about it. And they made it. So never ever underestimate what you can do. In the executive committee, that's my humble advice, I'm done. In the executive committee, dear respected imams, we did our best to serve you. You might think that Naif is doing nothing. You have the right to say so if you don't know what we did. But for your information, last year, minimum of 7 imams being hired through Naif. We get involved in at least 3 problems. And alhamdulillah, we solve it peacefully. One of these problems being solved last conference when I invited the head of the president of the center and the imam. And I told them, we'll discuss your problem after the conference. And after the conference, I told them, we are ready if you want to discuss it. They said, alhamdulillah, our problem is being solved. We do know that the imams work hard like this. After they heard what's the imam's job, and the imam himself, Jazallah kul khair, he was very humble. He said, I am part of the problem. I'm sorry, I will improve myself. So alhamdulillah rabbil alamin. Also, Naif helped many imams in financial situations. They get into financial problems and we try our best. We did not do a lot. We did not do a lot, but alhamdulillah rabbil alamin, at least the imam, when he was in financial problems, he finds someone to cope. We are not going to give thousands or even thousands, but at least he finds someone to worry about him. And this one is North American Imams Federation, have 587 members. It's not a joke. You are very strong together. So we did a lot, alhamdulillah rabbil alamin, but in the same time, we have a lot of shortcomings as well. If you want to count the positive, absolutely we have negative things. And when you have mistakes, means that you are working. If someone tell me, I never done any mistake, I said, you are sleeping. You are not doing anything. The minute you start working, absolutely there is mistakes. And we have a lot of mistakes. But instead of point fingers and criticizing us, come forward to us. Give us your idea. Share with us what you want to see. And we are going to implement what your ideas, regardless. Our executive committee meeting, I said it's open for every imam. And each one participating in this conference has the right to say whatever he wants and to vote. This is my policy. Have right to vote. Yes, you are not executive committee member, but it doesn't mean anything to me. Have the right to vote. The minute we acknowledge you are a leader, you are an imam, we have to listen to you. And this is our policy in the executive committee. And this direction, I've been getting from the board of trustees. Jazakumullah khair. They said, get involved all imams in your meetings. Have them vote. We don't follow the direction because the minute we consider you and acknowledge that you are a leader, we have to listen. So please, we have shortcomings. Don't start counting because you will get sick and tired of writing. Don't write our mistakes because it will be a lot. And I think your pen will run out of ink. And instead of that, just come to us, share with us your ideas in the executive meeting. We all listen to you, inshallah ta'ala. We have no problem to do anything you ask us to do if it's in the right direction. So, jazakumullah khair. We need your help. In the election session this year, I have an idea I would like to share it with you, which is, I think the election, it won't work with us. Instead of election, I would like to ask specific people who I know that they want to work, number one, and I ask you, any one of you, who want to work. We don't want election. We try it 10 years. It did not work. If you're willing to work and be in the executive committee member, please, you just stand up and we select, not elect. That's my idea. The board of trustees might accept it or reject it. The same thing, you are General Assembly, you might accept or reject this idea. But please, we want to do something to make sure those who are in the executive committee works with us. Not titles, we need titles and actions. That's all what I want to say to my dear respected brothers. Please forgive me personally for my shortcoming. Forgive our committee, executive committee, for what we have done wrong. And our intention is to do the best, but we are human beings. I think after now I finish my 5 minute speech, they give me 15, but I am so generous. I will donate you for you 7 minutes. So now our MC will be Sheikh Imam Amin Al Ali, and I will sit there waiting for any direction. Jazakumullahu anna kullu khair.
One of the most important things, brothers, that you have to smile and laugh. Because I will not collect any money. In general, people, when you ask them for money, they do not smile. Please smile. We are still in the morning. That's right. And I suggest to Dr. Omar that we can start our program later on at 10 o'clock. But I just find out that they start at 8 o'clock. But it's happened every time in our meetings. So the next speaker, inshallah, our beloved brother, Dr. Salah Sari.
Assalamu alaikum, everybody. Before we start, we would like to first of all welcome everybody, and we would like to especially welcome the newcomers. So if anybody is, this is the first time for anyone to attend Naif, please stand up. If this is the first time, لو هذه أول مرة لإخواننا أحد إخواننا يحضر Naif, if this is the first time, please stand up. MashaAllah.
Stay
up. We would give everybody just 1 minute, inshallah, to introduce yourself. Special welcome for them. Marhaban bikum. We got, believe it or not, we got a brother or two, maybe two, coming all the way from Nigeria, right? Some brothers coming from Nigeria straight to our conference. And we have another brother coming from Jordan. Two brothers coming from Jordan, mashallah. So, if you're coming from Phoenix or California or Florida, that's not too far. We have some people coming from a different continent, من قارة أخرى, يعني عبر البحار والقفار. That's Allah Azza wa Jalla. Just 1 minute, everybody, to introduce
yourself. They came directly from the for this convention, or they lived here and they were in vacation. No, they're coming for this convention. They came from Nigeria. They are care about us very much.
Assalamu alaikum. I am very happy to be here, first time. May Allah bless you all. My name is Dawood Aygün. I am originally from Turkey. I came from Boston, Massachusetts, Islamic Center of Lowell. I brought a lot of salam from my community. Again, I am so glad to be here. Jazakumullah khair.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. My name is Jawad, and I am from Atlantic City, New Jersey.
Jazakumullah khair. I'm very happy to be here. And I feel embarrassed to be sitting in the front here as a student with all of the mashayikh here. And I hope to learn a lot all throughout this journey, inshallah.
We still have some brothers on their way, coming for the first time. I know that, but inshallah, we welcome those who are here.
Assalamu alaikum. My name is Hatim Hamidullah. I am one of the imams in the Central Florida area with the Islamic Society of Central Florida. And there with one of the masajid under that umbrella. And the masjid is called Masjid al-Haq, downtown Orlando. I'm very happy to be here. May Allah's hands be upon this movement, inshallah. And very happy and proud to be part of this mission.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. My name is Mahmoud Ahmed. I'm involved with the Imam Council of Canada. I live in Toronto for a quarter of a century and we have a lot of development. And also, I'd like to share with you what we know, and also I'd like to learn from you. I'm a good student for other experiences, and we could develop and we could understand more of our effort, inshallah.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh, everyone. My name is Hassan Mahmoud, or Hassan Salim, whichever you like to call me with, but Hassan is fine. And I'm the Imam of the Islamic Center of Cedar Rapids. And for those, the Cedar Rapids in Iowa, for those of you who know, Cedar Rapids has the longest standing mosque in North America, the longest standing mosque in North America. It was built in 1934, and our Islamic Center is considered the daughter of this Mother Mosque of America. We call it the Mother Mosque of America. So it's a very diverse community. I'm here on behalf of my community to learn from all of you here. I see many people, or many imams and mashayikh, who are more learned and have more experience than me. Our center is a little bit, you know, struggling, and the goal of they sent me here to learn as much as I can, so that inshallah I can go back and implement everything I learned from you all, and hopefully inshallah advance our center and be part of advancing the ummah in all. Thank you. Barakallahu.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. I'm happy to be here. My name is Muhammad Miktababa. I'm from New York City, and I come from Fouta Islamic Center, where I do my activities. A part of the brothers over there to help them make the da'wah and to enlighten the youth. So I'm really happy to be part of you, to learn from you, and to gain good experience to help guide the Muslim Ummah, inshallah, and to develop them to better future, inshallah.
What's your name,
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
Alaykum
assalam. My name is Amidu Adino Jimo, a PhD holder in Arabic linguistics from the World Islamic Science University in Amman, and African president of International Moderation Forum, which was established in Jordan, and registered under the Ministry of Foreign Affairs in Jordan. I came here to, because knowledge is give and take. We know that the Aima, the Imams in America, they expose, and how we want to know how they are trying to implement Islamic study, and what they are doing to succeed in their activities in a society that the originally are not Islamic society. So I really hope that you can gain from them if they be able to succeed in implementing and spreading Islamic knowledge in the community that's not in Islam is a stranger in it. And we hope that you can gain from them and implement this kind of ideology and the system of way in our community in Africa and Middle East. Assalamu alaikum.
My name is Abdulazak Abdulaziz Shola.
a member of League Council of League of Imam and Alfa and Ulama in southwestern Nigeria, a member of National Society Committee. I have a lot of activities that I engage in. I came here to talk to, as our scholar said this morning, when we finish prayer, Alaykum Adullah, whichever you see the wisdom, try to grab it. So I came here to see the Tamilis facing the Ahidma in the minority, in the Muslim minority community, so that I can go back to my to Nigeria to see how we can disseminate the. So that is the reason I came here. Assalamu alaikum.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah. Your brother in Islam, Jihad Fadur, and professor of telecommunication and network security, as well as the president and founder of Syria Relief and Development. I came from Kansas City and I work in Bloomington, Norman, Illinois. So I heard about Naif, this is the first time. I really, from my heart, I would like to thank the people who really put this together. I remember the first day when they started, actually, Brother Dr. Al-Tayyib, we were together, and I was very supportive to this idea. And alhamdulillah, now I can see it alive. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reward you. This is great work. And I would push and support the effort to be more organized, really. As Dr. Omar said, you can make a big difference, really. Not only in the United States, but really abroad. So you're, working together and really supporting each other. You will unify the work here as well as support the work in abroad, inshallah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala support you. Thank you.
Assalamu alaikum. My name is Wael Mukhtar. I'm not an imam. I serve as the president of the executive committee in the Tawheed Masjid in Grand Rapids. It's really my pleasure to be in the same room with so many imams at the same time. This is the first time in my life that I sit in the same room with so many imams. So may Allah bless your effort and guide all of us to the right path.
Assalamu alaikum. Ismi Manaf Ahmed Kitani. Ana hadart min al-Urdun. Doctorate in Dirasat al-Islamiyya. تخصص فلسفة بناء التربية الإسلامية وهو يجمع تخصص ما بين بناء الفلسفة التربية الإسلامية ما بين التربية الإسلامية والتربية الغربية. حضرت لحضور هذا المؤتمر وكذلك مؤتمر الجمعية الإسلامية الأمريكية ماس سيقوم إن شاء الله بعد شهر من الآن، وكذلك أعمل معهم مع الأخوة في ماس في قضية بناء مناهج التربية الإسلامية عندهم في معهد ماس حفظ القرآن الكريم. وجزاكم الله خير.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Not used to being last, but we say last but not least. My name is Imam Hamayun Baksh. I'm from Imam of Masjid al-Nusar in New York. I'm also the regional manager in Northeast Zone for Al-Fuqan for AND project, as you see our booth outside. I'm here with my colleague Imam Isa from North Carolina. And inshallah, it's my pleasure to be with all the mashayikh, the Imam, to interact with. Inshallah, take ideas, get help, and at the same time develop ourselves. Inshallah, to do something. JazakAllah for doing that. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa
barakatuh. My name is Ali Haji Abdunur. I'm from San Diego, California. I'm one of the founders of Masjid al-Ansar al-Islami in San Diego, mostly runs the Somali community in San Diego. And I'm also president of HARO, Humanitarian African Relief Organization. And I'm very happy to attend this meeting and to see this shining face of the ulama, our big shaykhs. And I will connect you to this one, and I will be attending every time, inshallah.
Thank you.
Just for your information, brother here from Nigeria, he came from Jordan. He is involved in a very good project, which is Litanal, Al-Tanal Al-Arabiya, which is the same system of the TOEFL. Anyone want to work in, study Arabic in Arabic in any university, or want to work in Arab country, he should take this exam. And Jordan, Dubai, Lebanon, and many other countries start implement this. So it is a big project, and Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen, and myself and Dr. Waleed Al-Minesi represent them in U.S. And by the way, Sheikh Amar Dabur, he forgot to bring the gift for the newcomers. So he is the man who forgot. Alaykum bihi.
Well, we're supposed to really appreciate the imams, but then I thought, what would be enough to appreciate imams, especially the new imams? And, you know, there's nothing enough to appreciate the imams. So, but I think of one thing that I can appreciate the imams through, which is the wasiyah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. We say, Jazakumullahu khayran. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give you the best for covering all of this distance. And Allah, I was thinking about, you know, I have limited, as far as the luggage, I have limited, you know, bags and stuff, and I would pay a lot for carrying those stuff. So I said, maybe you can thank the imams and appreciate them. And then, barbu al-yaqeen wa hararat al-iman, inshallah, will be enough to appreciate everybody, inshallah. Marhaban bikum bayna ikhwanikum wa bayna sadr ulama wa al-mashayikh. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless your step, and may Allah give all of us the best, inshallah.
مرة أخرى جزاكم الله كل خير بارك الله فيكم بس لو نعرف how many PhDs we have right now with us. Can you raise your hand please?
How many?
PhDs, who has PhDs? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 دكتور صلاح لا ترفع 7, 8 لا لا بعدين بحكي كذا طيب ماشي جزاكم الله خير نعم
الرقم
25 طيب تفضل دكتور صلاح لان السيشن كيف يطور الايمان نفسه علميا وعمليا واجتماعيا جيد انه من الاخوه لما كتبوا العنوان كتبوا ضمن المحددات الثلاثه اجتماعيا سهل جدا قلت كما بدات حديثي انه لن تسعوا الناس باموالكم ولكن تسعوهم ببشاشه الوجه الكوميونتي كلها تحتاج من الشيخ انه يكون بشوش في كثير من الائمه يا اخي كانه داخل في معركه بس يطلع على الصلاه وهذا خطا ولا في اجمل من تصرف النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم في مثل هذا الشيء كلنا يعلم كان يسلم على الصغير والكبير كانت الجاريه تاخذ بيده صلى الله عليه وسلم الطفله الصغيره وتطوف به المدينه صلى الله عليه وسلم فاذا كان الانسان بشوش الوجه فقد كسب الجارية والجارية يا إخوة منا وفينا ونحن منهم وفيه لم نأتي من كوكب آخر ولم يأتوا من كوكب آخر ولذلك هذا سهل جدا يستطيع الإنسان أن يفعل من نفسه كثيرا فيه والدكتور إن شاء الله سيتحفنا به أكثر وأكثر وأترك له المجال العلمي والعمل أسأل الله سبحانه وتعالى أن يفتح عليه وأن يبارك فيه if anyone wants to translate the words of Dr. Salah, you can go there and pick up one of those programs, inshallah.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم إن الحمد لله نحمده سبحانه ونستعينه ونستهديه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا إنه من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل الله فلا هادي له ولن تجد له وليا مرشدا أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله اللهم صل على محمد النبي وأزواجه أمهات المؤمنين وذريته وآل بيته كما صليت ربنا على آل إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد ثم ارض اللهم عن أصحاب نبيك أجمعين وأجمع معهم برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين. ثم أما بعد، فقد بلغت أن موضوع هذه الكلمة دور المشايخ وأصحاب الفضيلة في النهضة للأمة. ثم أخذت أجيب النظر في واقع الأمة كالقافلة المقروبة تتخبط منذ زمن طويل في مجاهد الأرض وقوادع السماء، وقد بهرتها الشدائد وأجهدتها المفاوز وفدحتها الضحايا. ثم دارت ببصرها في معاني الفضاء لا تكاد تتبين محما بطريق ولا تتعرف وجها لآخر. ثم يقف بعض أدلائها وبعض روادها لكي يلتهموا زادها مع الوحش، لكي يقتسموا مالها مع المغير، لكي يغتنموا ضلالها مع الحوادث. ثم دور الأئمة، المشايخ والعلماء، المصابيح المضيئة في حياة البشر، العلماء الربانيون، فإن الانتساب إلى العلم وإلى الدعوة إلى الله شرف لا يدانيه شرف وعلاء لا يطاوله علاء. ثم حسبهم من المكانة والمنزلة قول الله جل وعلا: إنما يخشى الله من عباده العلماء، وقول النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم: إن الله وملائكته وأهل السماوات وأهل الأرض حتى النملة في جحرها وحتى الحوت ليصلون على معلم الناس الخير. ثم يروي الحسن البصري عن بعض أصحاب رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم قوله: إن شئتم أقسمت لكم بالله أن أحب عباد الله إلى الله الذين يحببون الله إلى عباده ويحببون عباد الله إلى الله. ثم قال: ويسعون في الأرض بالنصيحة. نؤكد على هذا المعنى في هذه المقدمة لأننا نعيش زمن الغربة الثانية للإسلام، كالغربة التي تتفاقم يوما بعد يوم، ثم يتجرع مرارتها كل مسلم غيور باق على عهد الله وميثاقه، لم يخن مع من خان ولم يبدل مع من بدل، بل بقي قابض على دينه كالقابض على الجمر، يحاول أن يدفع عن الإسلام بكلمة أو حتى أن ينجو في الإسلام بنفسه. في غمرة هذه الغربة الكالحة تشن الغارة على الدين، ثم يشيطن دعائه، ثم يشيطن دعاته، ثم تشيطن دعوته، ثم يشيطن منهجه، ثم تشيطن كل مظاهره وكل صوره أو كثير منها. في غمرة هذا كله يأتي دور مؤتمرنا هذا لكي ينعقد في ظروف بالغة الدقة وبالغة الحرج. في مقامنا هذا وفي الوقت المحدود المتاح لهذه الكلمة، لا يسعنا إلا أن نشير فقط إلى بعض العناوين والمعالم البارزة. فشأننا كمن يحلق بالطائرة في سماء مدينة كبيرة شاسعة متغيرة. فسوف نقف على بعض اللقطات الكبرى الرئيسة التي أرجو أن ينفع الله تعالى بها. أول معلم أرجو أن يقوم به إلى علم إن شاء الله: استفاضة البلاغة بالوسطية الإسلامية، الوقوف في وجه دعوات الغلو وفي وجه دعوات الشفط، في أعقاب الفتن، في أعقاب الكوارث، في أعقاب النكبات العامة، لتشيع بعض موجات الغلو. نعم، فتشيع موجة من موجات الغلو في التكفير، وده يعتبر طبيعي. رد فعل يعني طبيعي مفهوم يمكن تفسيره وإن كان لا يمكن تسويغه ولا يمكن تبريره. سوف يقول كثير من الناس يعني هل هؤلاء الذين فعلوا ما فعلوا هل يمكن أن يكونوا مسلمين؟ ثم يبدأ هذا السؤال يعني تعقوه أسئلة من جنسه إلى أن تشيع من خلاله موجة من موجات الغلو في التفكير. يعني وأنا حريص على تعبير يعني كلمة الغلو في التكفير، نعم، لأن التكفير في ذات الحق التكفير موجود في القرآن وموجود في السنة. لقد كفر الذين قالوا إن الله ثالث ثلاثة وما من إله إلا إله واحد، فبما نقضي ميثاقهم وكفرهم بآيات الله وقتلهم الأنبياء بغير حق وقولهم قلوبنا غلف بل طبع الله عليها بكفرهم فلا يؤمنون إلا قليلا وبكفرهم وقولهم على مريم بهتانا. فثلاث مرات من الوصف بالكفر في آيتين على التوراة. نعم، لكن حديثنا عن الغلو في التكفير، وتلك قضية سوف تشيع وتنتشر وتتسع رقعتها، ولا بد أن ترد إلى جادة الحق، ولا بد أن يرد أصحابها إلى جادة أهل السنة والجماعة. في تكفير تقليدي سائل بسيط يعني يعتبر من مواريث الخوارج، تكفير بالذنوب والمعاصي، يعني والرد على هذا ميسور ومقدور لأنه شاع في فترة من فترات التاريخ وكتب أهل العلم حافلة بالرد عليه، واستقر في فقه أهل السنة قديما وحديثا أن المعاصي من أمور الجاهلية لا يكفر فاعلها بارتكابها إلا بالشرك، لقول الله جل وعلا إن الله لا يغفر أن يشرك به ويغفر ما دون ذلك لمن يشاء. ولتفاوت العقوبات المقدرة شرعا على المعاصي المختلفة، ولو كانت المعاصي سواء لكانت العقوبة واحدة، إن يعني إن العقوبات تفاوتت من قطع إلى الجلد إلى الرجم إلى التعزير إلى القصاص، وكل هذا إنما يدل على تفاوت المعاصي الموجبة لهذه العقوبات. وفي كتاب الله جل وعلا نقرأ قول الله تعالى وكره إليكم الكفر والفسوق والعصيان، فدل هذا على التفريق ما بين الكفر من جانب وما بين الفسوق والعصيان من جانب. نعم، هناك تكفير آخر أكثر تعقيدا اللي بينطلق من قضية المرجعية والحاكمية، طلب من قضية الولاء والبراء وتجلياتها وتطبيقاتها، وهذا تكفير يحتاج الرد عليه إلى تؤدة يعني وإلى روية وإلى استماع جيد لأصحابه وإلى منطلقاتهم. نعم، لأن بعضه حق يعني ولأن كثيرا منه باطل، فتحتاج أن تفصل ما بين الحق الذي تقبله وما بين الباطل الذي ترده. إشاعة مفاهيم الوسطية معلم من معالم التنوير وثغر من ثغور حراسة الدين التي ينبغي ألا نغفل عنها في هذه المرحلة. كما تشيع موجة من موجات الغلو في التكفير في أعقاب المحن، أيضا وبنفس القدر تشيع موجة من موجات التجهم والإرجاء، وهذه أكبر مدى وأكثر اتساعا، لأن النفس يعني بطبيعتها تحب أن تجد يعني ما يعزيها وما يجعلها تتكيف مع الواقع الجديد الذي قد فرض عليها عنوة. وفي تاريخنا يعني من درس تاريخنا دراسة جيدة سوف يدرك أن في كل موجة انكسار وفي كل موجة أزمة كانت تمر بها أمتنا كانت تشيع بعدها موجة من موجات الرجاء. أقول لك أقام العباد في مأرى، دع الخلق للخالق، تعيش تغير الكون يا أخي ولو شاء ربك ما فعل، وربنا عايش فيك. وده مورفين جميل، مورفين جميل بين كلر يهدئ ويروى النفوس ويبختنا بالنبي، يبختنا بالنبي خلاص الدنيا الموضوع يخلص كده. واقع جديد عجز الناس عن مقاومته عجز الناس عن مراغمته فالحل تقبله وترويض النفوس وتطبيعها للتعامل معه ومن ثم كما نحتاج إلى الرد على الغلو في التكفير نحتاج إلى الرد على غلو المقابل أرجو أن ننتبه إليه فهو لا يقل يعني لا يقل خطورة ولا يقل اغتيالا لعقائد الأمة ولا يقل اغتيالا لوعيها عن المسألة الأولى وهي قضية الغلو في التكفير فأرجو أن ننتبه إلى هذا وأن ننتبه إلى ذاك ورقة. ومن المعالم التي أرجو أن ننتبه إليها معالجة قضية الاختلاف لأن طبيعة أعقاب المحن يعني يحدث التلاوم ثم منه تنشأ قضية التشرذم والاختلاف يعني هذا يدوم وهذا ينتقد وهذا يفعل فتنشأ قضية التشرذم والتحوصل ويتفرق الناس بشيعا وأحزابا فإشاعة فقه الاختلاف وأدبه وحسن التعامل مع هذه القضية وتحويلها إلى ثقافة عامة وتبسيط التعامل بها وتبسيط عرضها للناس في مساجدنا في منائرنا في منابرنا في محاضراتنا مسألة في غاية أهمية لا بد أن نفرق للناس بين الاختلاف في الفروع وبين الاختلاف في الأصول الاختلاف في الفروع في قضايا الفقه في مسائل الاجتهاد لا ينبغي أن يكون معقد ولا إنورا لا ينبغي أن يفسد للود قضية الزكشي رحمه الله يقول اعلم أن الله تعالى لم ينصب على جميع الأحكام الشرعية أدلة قاطعة ثم قال بل جعلها ضمنية قصدا من أجل التوسعة على المكلفين نعم ولو شاء ربك أن يكون القرآن والسنة على نحو لا يحتملان في الفهم إلا وجها واحدا ما أعجزه ذلك يعني لو أراد ربك أن يكون القرآن كله قطعية الدلالة أن تكون السنة كلها قطعية الدلالة ما أعجزه يعني لكن لحكمة يعلمها الله جل وعلا جعل من نصوص الوحي ما هو محكم قطعي يمثل الشرع المحكم الذي تجتمع حوله كلمة المسلم ثم جعل من نصوصهما ما هو متشابه ظني كي يمثل دائرة السعة والمرونة في الشريعة فكلما ضاق الأمر بالأمة في مذهب التمست السعة والمرونة في مذهب آخر وفق ما ترجحه الأدلة ويحقق المصلحة العامة لجماعة المسلمين وكلكم أصحاب الفضيلة يعلم أن الإمام مالك قد عرض عليه ثلاثة من خلفاء بني العباس على التوالي أن يجعلوا من كتابه الموطأ المرجع الأعلى للدولة الإسلامية وأن يلزموا به الأمة كافة لكنه أبى رحمه الله ثم يعلق الحافظ ابن كثير على هذا فيقول كان هذا من تمام علمه وعدله واتصافه بالإنصاف رحمه الله يعني فتلك قضية أرجو أن ننتبه إليها يعني ثم يكمل الحديث هذا إذا كان الاختلاف في الأصول مذموما لكنه لا يعني الاحتراب لا يعني التقاطب يعني لابد أن يجد عقلاء الناس صيغة التعايش ويحضرني في هذا المقام كلمة علي بن أبي طالب رضي الله عنه للخوارج خوارج كانوا من أشد الناس قتالا للأمة ومن أشد الناس بغيا عليها ومن أشد الناس خروجا على جماعته لكنه قال لهم لكم علينا ثلاث ألا نمنعكم مساجد الله أن تزقوا فيها سلام ألا نبدأكم بقتال من تقطعوا السبيل وتسفكوا الدم الحرام ألا نمنعكم من الغنيمة والفيء ما دامت أيديكم يعني وصل إلى صيغة يمكن رغم أنهم يكفرون المسلمين ويأخذون عليهم يقتلون أهل الإسلام ويدعون أهل الأوثان ومن أشد الناس بغيًا ومن هذا قدم هذا المقترح لهم ليمنع الاحتراب الداخلي ما أمكن لكي يمنع الاقتتال الداخلي ما أمكن لأن من كان على رأس الناس من كان خليفة سلطانا إماما يعني فهو يعني أمير على الكل
يعني وهو مسؤول عن جميع السنة والبدعة يعني كل ألوان الطيف داخل المجتمع الإسلامي. من كان على رأس هذا المجتمع فإنه مسؤول أن يحقق صيغة من صيغ التعايش التي يمكن أن تمنع الاحتراب وأن يجتمع حولها الناس في مشترك عام من الخير. نعم. وإذا كان النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم قد قال لأهل مكة يوم الحديبية والذي نفسي بيده لا يسألوني خطة يعظمون فيها حرمات الله إلا أعطيتهم إياها، إذا وسع هذا القول مشرك مكة، إذا كان نبينا يقول لمشرك مكة لا تسألوني خطة تعظمون فيها حرمات الله إلا أعطيتهم إياها، فالبر أولى أن يتسع هذا لأهل القبلة ممن كان عندهم أصل أو اثنين أو أكثر من الأصول البدعية الزائغة عن الحق. اللهم اهدنا يا ربي سواء السبيل. الحديث عن النهضة أحبابي حديث عن تقدم شامل في مختلف المجالات، يعني لكن له جناحان، جناح تقني يعني وجناح إيماني. التقنية والتزكية إن صح التعبير، يعني فهما جناحان تطير بهما النهضة وبغيرهما تصبح النهضة كسيحة وتصبح النهضة شلاء. ومن الجمال في كتاب الله عز وجل تعبير ذي القرنين عندما قال بعد أن أتم صناعة السد، وهو عمل تقني بحث، آتوني زبر الحديد كذا، عمل تقني بحث، ثم قال هذا رحمة من رب، هذا رحمة من رب. فإذا جاء وعد ربي جعله زكاء وكان وعد ربي حقا. اجتماع الجناحين معا تطير بهما يعني النهضة وبدونهما لا تتحقق. يعني فنحن كما أننا في حاجة إلى مشايخنا وعلمائنا لكي يحرصوا ديننا، لكي يجددوه علما وعملا، كي يستفيض البلاغ من خلالهم بحقائقه عقائد وشرائع، في حاجة أيضا إلى رعاية الباحثين المسلمين التقنيين والمتخصصين في المجالات المختلفة، وأن ينقل التدين إلى هؤلاء. كيف ننقل يعني روح استقامة وروح التدين إلى هؤلاء، لأن هؤلاء الجناح الثاني اللي من خلاله تتحقق النهضة الشاملة للأمة. تبارك الله. مسألة إحياء يعني الاجتهاد الجماعي مسألة مهمة في نوازلنا المعاصرة، أكبر من أن يقوم لها إمام واحد أو فقيه واحد أو حتى مجتهد واحد على ندرة المجتهدين أو قلتهم وربما انعدامهم في واقعنا المعاصر. فإحياء ما يتعلق بالاجتهاد الجماعي يبعدنا كثير للنظر في الموازن وعرضها في تناقش الاجتهادات الجماعية وتصدر فيها قرارات مجمعية. أرجو أن ينتبه إلى هذا المعاني المهمة. مسألة التعصب الإنساني، نحن الآن نمر بكوارث كبيرة اجتاحت كل فصائل الفرد، لم يكن يسلم منها أحد. يعني فهل أنا لأمتنا أن تخرج من عقدة التعصب الحزبي؟ أنا لا أقول التحزب، إنما التحديد التعصب الحزبي. نعم، لأن التحزب بمعنى الاجتماع على عمل من أعمال الخير، يعني وأن ينظم الناس اجتماعهم هذا وأن يلتزموا الطاعة المقدمة وأضع له قواعد تضبط سيره ومساره، كلام جميل ومشروع لا منازع في هذا. لقد سئل شيخ الإسلام ابن تيمية رحمه الله، سئل عن جماعة من الناس يسمون حزبا ويتخذون لهم رأسا ويدعون إلى بعض الشيء فقط، إن كانوا مجتمعين على ما أمر الله به ورسوله من غير زيادة ولا نقصان فهم مؤمنون لهم ما للمؤمنين وعليهم ما. ثم قال وإن كانوا قد زادوا في ذلك أو نقصوا بالتعصب لمن دخل في حزبهم بالحق وبالطاعة وبالإعراض عمن لم يكن معهم سواء أكان على الحق أم على الباطل.
فإن هذا هو التحزب الموجود أو إن هذا هو التعصب الموجود الذي يسخطه الله ورسوله. فإن الله ورسوله أمر بالجماعة والاختلاف ونهي عن الفقر. فإن الله ورسوله أمر بالجماعة والاختلاف ونهي عن الفقر والاختلاف. ثم قال وأمر بالتعاون على البر والتقوى ونهي عن التعاون على الإثم والعدوان. فالمقصود في هذا المقال ليس إنكار على مبدأ الاجتماع على أعمال الخير أو تنظيم الناس في أوعية فاعلة، إنما إنكار في هذا المقام إنما ينصرف إلى التعصب الحزبي إلى الغلو في هذا، بحيث لا يرى أحدا على الحق إلا من كان معه، يعني ثم لا يرى شيئا من الحق ممن لم يكن معه، يعني التعصب لمن كان في حزبه بالحق وبالباطل، وبالإعراض عمن لم يكن في حزبه سواء كان على الحق أم على الباطل. طيب مسألة أخرى، إشاعة ثقافة الألفة، إشاعة ثقافة ومفاهيم الألفة والاجتماع، واعتصم بحبل الله جميعا ولا تنازعوا. الله جل وعلا يقول ولا تنازعوا فتفشلوا وتذهب ريحكم أصلا. الدفع يعني بمؤسساتنا نحو قيادة هذا العمل، وأنا بقترح على حضراتكم يعني أقترح مبادرة من ثلاث شعب. الشعبة الأولى تتعلق بنيف، وأرجو أن تسمعني أخي الدكتور عمر شاهين بارك الله فيك. أخي الدكتور عمر أرجو أن تستمع إلي إن كنت موجودا. الشعبة الأولى فيما تتعلق بتطوير عمل نيف، سابقة رائدة جدا في مجال العمل الإسلامي في هذا البلد، يعني لكن تطويرها أرجو أن تمتد يعني شعبها وأن تستفيد من تجربة الكير. عايز يبقى عندي نيف هيوستن، نيف كاليفورنيا، نيف كذا، تبقى لنا مكاتب في كل ولاية من الولايات، وأهل كل ولاية يشتغلوا على مكتبهم ويشتغلوا على تجمعهم، ويبقى عندهم مرجعية إدارية في منطقتهم. أنا كأني أنظر كنيف مع تجاوز التعبير كأنها مثلا وزارة الأوقاف، يعني ترعى جيل الأئمة وترعى شؤون الدعوة، نواحي إدارية وقنظومية وكذا وكذا، وكونها نقابة من النقابات التي ترعى الأئمة تحافظ على حقوقهم. فتلك هي المبادرة الأولى، تطوير عمل كير، تطوير عمل كير، الاستفادة من تجربة كير، إن إحنا نخلي في كل ولاية من الولايات ما أمكن أن يكون كل فريق من الأئمة في منطقتين يشكلون نيف المحلي، نيف تكساس، نيف يعني فلوريدا، أريزونا كذا، وفي مكتب رئيس وفي مكاتب محلية نستطيع أن يرجع عليها يعني الأئمة محليا، ثم تتوزع المسؤوليات والمهام على هذا النحو بين مكتب رئيس وما بين مكاتب محلية، ويكون بينها من التنسيق والتآزر والتحاضر والتعاون ما ينتظم به أكل هذه المسيرة المباركة إن شاء الله. المسألة الثانية بارك الله فيكم، يعني اهتمام بقضية الاجتهاد الجماعي من خلال أنجا، يعني أنا أرجو أن تعتبروا أنجا كأنها دار إفتاء، يعني إذا قلنا ليش كأنها بمثابة وزارة الأوقاف، خلينا نعتبر أن كأنها دار إفتاء، وأرجع منكم وبكم وبيدكم، وكل مقترحاتكم بتطويرها وتحسينها مقترحات مقبولة ومسموعة ومقدرة إن شاء الله. يعني قد يكون أداؤها في الفترة الماضية شابه بعض الوهن، لكن والله على شفط من العيش وعلى نقص من الأموال والأنفس والثمرات استطاعت أن تقدم 11 مؤتمر دولي، وأن تقدم 11 أو 12 دورة تدريبية لأصحاب الفضيلة داخل الولايات المتحدة، وموضوعها القادم في مارس في شيكاغو هنا حول نوازل المساجد خارج التيار الإسلامي. المسجد كمسجد ما هي نوازله؟ وعارفين الدورة الماضية كانت حول تمويل شراء البيوت و يعني أنتم أعضاء جميع فيها فربما تعرفون ما قدمته وإلى الآن ليس لديها مدير تنفيذي ثم عملت إعلان عام قالت نحن نريد مديرا تنفيذيا يجمع لنا بين الحكاية والديانة وأعلنت هذا في مختلف وسائل يعني التواصل الاجتماعي ومن عنده ترشيح أرجو أن لا يدخل علينا هذا الترشيح بارك الله فيكم المدير التنفيذي مش المقصود أن يكون إماما أو أن يكون عالما لا يكون عنده يعني مهنية إدارية كفاية إدارية وكفاية تنفيذية طبعا إذا جمع علم شرعي الحمد لله لكن المقصود في المقام الأول جانب الكفاية المهنية والتنفيذية يعني والتقنية الشخصية على القناة العامة بحيث تظهر كثير من المشروعات التي يمكن أن تقدم من خلال وقد خطت خطوات كبيرة وأنا أشهد الله عز وجل في حدود اجتهادي ورؤيتي البشرية إن أبدأ حافظت على التوازن في عالم الفتوى لم تنبطح مع المنبطحين ولم تغلو مع المتعصبين حاولت أن تخط منهج الوسطية ما استطاعت إلى ذلك السبيل لأني يعني من المزالق التي يتعرض لها مشايخنا أو بعض مشايخنا الغلو في منهج الكنيسي وقد بلغ بنا الأمر وأبلغ أن بعض أساتذة الفقه المقارن الكبار جداً لهم أسماء كبيرة أي رأي موجود في كتب التراث يمكن أن يكون الشريعة ويمكن أن يكون ديناً سواء كان زلة من الزلات غلطة من الغلطات، سقطة من السقطات لا يفرق بين زلة العالم التي ينبغي أن تنافس يعني فلا تزاح ولا تشاع وبين الاجتهاد المعتبر تعلمون قول الناظم وليس كل خلاف جاء معتبرا إلا خلاف له حظ من النظر يعني فالغلو في منهج التيسير باب من أبواب المزاج والحقيقة المزالق التي نتعرض لها كثيرة فمن بينها هذا المزلق ومن بينها مزلق عدم قدرة العالم على يعني الانعتاق من تأثير تلاميذه ومريديه أو الانعتاق من يعني ملقة السلاطين وعندنا عالم سلطان وعندنا عالم عامة وهذا أحد طرفي الغلو وهذا يمثل الطرف الثاني يعني في واحد عالم عامة ما يطلبه المستمعون لا يستطيع أن ينعتق من تأثير تلاميذه عليه ما هو الجو العام تلاميذه تكفيني جفر معه توسع نتوسع معه لا يعني المسألة لا علاقة لها لا بهذا الطرف ولا بذلك يعني أنت تمثل النبي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وأنت أحد ورثته فإن الأنبياء لم يورثوا دنانير ولا دراهم كما ورثوا هذا العلم فمن أخذ منه على قدر أخذ الناس منه على قدر حظهم من وراثة الله فالاهتمام بأمجاد يعني واعتمادها كمرجع ما تصدره من يعني قرارات المجمعية من إعلان قضية الهلال وأرجو أن تقدموها إلى جالياتكم وأي شخصية فقهية لها دور يمكن أن تقدمه إلى أمجاد أرجو أن لا تبخلوا علينا يعني بتقديمها وتعريف العالم المحور الثاني في هذه المبادرة فيما يتعلق بالجامعات لا إن شاء الله معرفة قبل الناس الجامعات الإسلامية في هذا الجامعات الإسلامية في هذا يعني أنا أقول لقد أنا الأوان لكي تلتقي تحت مظلة واحدة إن تفرقنا يضعف إن تشتتنا يمزق يعني فقد آن يعني جاءت اللحظة التي ينبغي أن نتقارب فيها وأن نتراص وأن نتضام كما نعيش ازدواجية في الملاهي وازدواجية في البرامج وازدواجية إلى ثلاثة وتذهب جهود كثيرة أدراك. فالمرة الثالثة أرجو من القادمين على الأرض في الجامعات الإسلامية أرجو أن يتضاموا أن يتقاربوا أن يتراصوا أن تتوحد صفوفهم. وبمناسبة الحديث عن هذا إنني أعلن أمامكم والله اللحظة التي يجتمع بها هؤلاء فأنا مستقيل من رئاسة الجامعة الإسلامية الأمريكية الشمالية للشام وأشهد على هذا أخي الدكتور عمر وهو نائب رئيس الجامعة الإسلامية للشام أشهد على هذا أمامكم جميعا حتى لا تكون هذه الدعوة فيه حظ لنفس الراية تعطى لمن يستحقها الراية تبذل لمن يقوم بحقها من الناطقين باللغة الإنجليزية في هذا البلد من عرفوا ثقافته ومن خبروا تاريخه نحن مجرد فقط يعني نحن ستار لقدر الله عز وجل نرجو أن تمر من خلال أقدار الله جل وعلا ونحن نستقبل الدنيا ونستقبل الآخرة وقد مر من عمرنا أطيبه وأسأل الله جل وعلا أن يرحمنا فيما فات يعني أن نهيئ لنا فيما نستقبله من أمرنا رشدا ونجمعنا وإياكم على محبة هذه الحياة وفي دار كرامة الإيمان إنه ولي ذلك والقادر عليه وشكر الله لكم حسن سماعكم وإصغائكم وسلام الله عليكم ورحمة الله
جزاك الله كل خير دكتور بارك الله فيك ومتع عليك وأمد في عمرك وأحسن عملك ونسأل الله سبحانه أن يحسن خاتمتنا وخاتمتك راح نفتح المجال لأخوة 5 minutes if anyone has any question for more questions أريح نحن ديكتاتوريين طيب ما في أسئلة الآن السيشن الثاني
رفعنا اليد هنا
تسأل الدكتور بيني وبينه الفائدة إن شاء الله نستفيد منها رضي الله عنه في الجلسة الختامية إن شاء الله موجود عندنا هنا راح يكون في بس دون السؤال الله يبارك فيه الآن السيشن الثاني مع حبيبنا الدكتور عمر هاو كان إمام زور فليتفضل مشكورا إن شاء الله وكنت أريد أن أعقب على كلمة حبيبنا الدكتور صلاح مين من الأئمة الكرام الأفاضل الأخوة الأحبة عنده فيسبوك يرفع يده.
مين عنده فيسبوك؟
حلال فيسبوك. ده لازم يكون جميع يا أخو. هذا من باب تطويرك علميا وعمليا أنا سأكثر على حبيبنا الدكتور عمر أن يصير نيف فيسبوك. أن كل الأئمة الموجودين يكونوا موجودين ضمن الفيسبوك تاع نيف بحيث أنه نتواصل دائما نتبادل الخبرات نتبادل ما يعني يستطيع الإنسان أن يفعله. الآن الميكروفون مع الدكتور عمر جزاه الله خيرا هو كان إمام سوء
السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. First of all, I would like to ask you please to fill the first row first because our sessions it's a group. We have workshop and we need you to fill the first row first, second, third as we go. So please come forward. Please, and fill this side, because this side they will get more reward, inshallah ta'ala. The Tiba' al-Sunnah. Bismillah, taqaddam afwani ala zinur. I want, before I start my session, I would like to give the great news for our beloved Sheikh, Dr. Salah al-Sami, the president of Mishkan. As Vice President, Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen, so far we have three big universities agree to merge under the umbrella of Mishkan. Alhamdulillah, it's a great news. And this project, inshaAllah ta'ala, with the help of Allah, first and last, and your support and other people, finance support, may Allah reward them. Say Ameen. May Allah bless them. Say Ameen. Inshallah ta'ala, within 18 months, you will see a big, strong Muslim university called Mishka. Under umbrella of this university, you will see all universities together working, inshallah. And one more time, I have a three agreement. verbal and writing from three big universities to work with us under one umbrella mishkan. Jazakallah, this is the good news for you, our beloved Sheikh. Now, we want to teach you some dancing. I would like you, this session, need you to be silent. Because when we start talking, we could not focus. I will ask some brothers to volunteer. And I would like to take me serious. We are making business.
So, for this, I'll take my jacket off.
Part of my PhD, the second one, it's how to convey the message to the audience without talking. How to teach people without lecturing. As we all know that, now lecturing, it's become like old-fashioned. Now people, they learn from the iPad, and iPad, and iPhone, and iPad for all of this, more than what they learned from lecturing. So let's focus in this, and this is what you can take from here to your community, especially the youth, attract the youth, give them a new methodology of teaching, how to attract them, how to look at their imam as a leader, because there is a gap between us and our community sometimes. So we need to fill this gap, inshallah. And this conference is to do so. So please take me serious. And anytime you want me to do this for your community, inshallah ta'ala, free of charge, I'm ready to do this. To give you just ideas. I cannot give you every old methodology, but ideas, some games, some exercises to teach the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam through these games. To make them, they love what they are learning. Instead of lecturing 45 minutes, lecturing, no one can handle it these days. No one. 45 minutes lecture, no one can sit and listen. So, I would like to pick some volunteers. Please help me and come forward. Who wants to be volunteer first?
What they are going to do?
Dance?
No, we can't.
No, not dancing. No, it's not dancing. The session is how to work together. How we can work together as imams, board of trustees, executive committee, or whatever. How we can work together. So we have the first imam volunteer. Tafadhal akhi. Sometimes I will pick according to tafadhal. What's your name? Adil. Why? What do you mean that? Okay, Jazakumullah khair. Okay, I need another brother, I will pick him, from Nigeria. Because I want two girls. I want a personal muscle, how many? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Need one more. 7, tafadhal. Sheikh Dr. Muhammad al-Ghubayshi, Sheikh Muhammad Hassan. You have two names. Hassan Mahmoud, Hassan Salim. And brother, Amin, from New York. Hadullahullah.
Adil Harzai,
Carolina. Carolina, mashallah.
Muhammad Hussein Khan, from Dallas.
From Dallas, Muhammad.
Asad Razak Abdali, from Nigeria.
Okay, alhamdulillah. This is how much it weighs. Half-time?
Yes.
Is it difficult to take this from up here to down?
No.
Is it a difficult job?
No.
It's easy, yes?
Yes.
I will give this job to our brothers. Please be silent here and let them do what they want. Can you do a circle here, please? The job is easy. Hold this, please. All of you hold it with your fingers like this. Two fingers. Ash-shahid. Two fingers. Like this.
Hold it, hold it.
two fingers. No, no. This one and the other one. Two hands.
Two fingers. الشاهد. Yes. Hold it this way, Ahi. Don't care, push it. This way, hold it. Ayo, that's perfect. Okay, let me get up. Their job, it's easy. To get this down with one condition, that their fingers should touch this thing until it reaches down. The minute one of them, his fingers not touch it, they have to restart again. Easy job. It's half pound. You are seven strong people and imams. Please be silent. Do whatever you want. Yes? I will watch you the minute I see any finger. Brother, don't push it out like this. Yes. Start over. Yes. Start over. Don't touch it from the top of it. Oh, okay. Start over. You finger. His finger. Start over. Start over. Hold on, hold it, Dr. Muhammad. No, 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 you can't go.
Okay. One brother replace him.
He doesn't like.
He has no patience. He has no patience, Akhi Muhammad. Yeah, Dr. Muhammad.
No, he doesn't like to work together.
Please give them the chance. Start over. Say Bismillah. Did you recite the Quran before? Okay. Brother, brother, not from here, from here, like this. Not from inside. No, no, like this, like this. And come here, why you are going there? Come here, don't. Start from the top here. Yes. Now we start.
If it goes one way, try to balance it out.
Okay. No, the brother is out.
No. Start over. Yeah? Allah is watching you. You have only 30 seconds. Last chance. That's it.
Let's count it. Seconds. Right, this is the screen.
Yeah. The minute you get your hands, you have to start. No, no, no. You have to start over. Yes. No, no, no. It should be up a little bit. Okay. Okay. According to his toe. Yeah. Okay, okay. Repeat. Jazakumullah. Okay. I need two brothers. Brother Adam. Now, brother Muhammad. Now Muhammad, he's now. I want you to do it. Both. The same thing. Up, 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 up. Yalla, bismillah.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10.
Great job. Takbir. I would like to hear now your comments for the first group. Why did not they did not make it? They did not make it. Why? Okay, number one. I can't hear one person at a time. Yes, sir.
They are too many.
They are too many. Whenever we have a project, assign the exact number you need for this project. Don't give a project need just two people, like this one, to seven people. You put too many people in a small project, your unit. Remember this. So basic number one, or rules number one, handle the project exact number it's need. Don't put too many people. Yes or no?
Yes.
We learn this? Whenever you have a project in your community, don't handle it to 100 people. You are in charge, 100 people. Don't do too many committees. Maybe one person can do better than 100 person. Yes or no? This is a very simple thing to get this down. When you handle it to two people, they will do it. But when you give it to seven people, they will never do it. For your information, through the history, no group did this. They can make it down. No one. So don't feel bad, Akhi, Dr. Muhammad. Number one. Number two.
This is what I quit from the beginning.
Brother Adel, Imam Adel said, they don't have a leader. Everybody, he took the, like the lead in this. Everybody start giving direction. Sheikh Muhammad is telling Brother Adel. Brother Adel telling the others. Nobody knows to listen to whom. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said, "La yahillu." Say, "La yahillu." لِثَلَاثَةٍ إِلَّا أَنْ يُؤَمِّرُ عَلَيْهِمْ إِذَا كُنْتُمْ ثَلَاثًا فَأَمِّرُوا أَحَدَكُمْ
فِي سَفَرٍ يَا أخي.
Yeah, if you were traveling and you are three and more, you have to assign what? A leader, one. Every committee needs a leader. And the leader without authority doesn't work. When you give leadership to someone, give him what?
Authority.
To be a leader with full meaning. This is rule number two. What is rule number one, Sheikh Raib? You forgot, Maulana. They said when you get old, you forgot the three things. Number one, my memory, and I forgot the other two. Ya Sheikh Raid, when? The Satak Shabab, mashallah. What is number one? Assign the exact number. Number two, ya Dr. Ahmad?
Leader.
Number three.
Now, what I want to say is that everyone has abilities, so they didn't understand what the abilities of the
others. Jazakallah khair. We should acknowledge other people's ability and what they can do and what they can't do. Simply because you cannot put, with my full respect, a short person with a very tall, like Brother Ahdil, in this thing.
Because no way that he can reach you, and you have to go down, that's what you need. So abilities, abilities. Bring the right people to your project. Don't bring anyone. If the board, any organization board, needs a person understand business, a person understand maintenance in the masjid, for example, a person who knows how to educate people, a person who has knowledge, like an imam. So all committees need to have one from a different aspect to represent this aspect. Otherwise, if we all imams and they put us in building a masjid, for example, it doesn't work. Because we need an engineer, we need a finance person, we need. So we need to work together and acknowledge each other's what ability and what they can do and what they can't do. What else? Yes, sir. Thank you very much. Before you start, ask me the rules. You need to understand the rules of everything before you start. Before you start anything in your life, know the rules. Understand the rules. Study the rules very well before you go ahead and do anything. That's number four. Repeat myself. Rule number one, ya Sheikh Abdul Basir. Remember. Exact number. Rule number two. Leader. Rule number three. Ability of each other. Number four. Explain the rules before you start. Any committee. I need to understand. Before I give the titles of chairman to this committee. What is the job description for this chairman? He doesn't know. So how he works? If I don't know my job description, can I function well? Can I do anything? Wallahi, I will destroy this organization before I build it. So we need to understand the rules. Number five. Yes, Imam Abdul Basir. Thank you. Lack of communication. But lack of communication, why? Because there is no leadership. Lack of communication. Sometimes, some imams, you send an email to them, maybe 1 year later, he said, "Ya Sheikh, you did not tell me about this." "No, brother, I told you. I sent an email." "Oh, I'm sorry, I did not check my email for the last 2 months." Excuse me, that's the communication. So lack of communication. We need to communicate with each other. If you establish any committee, you need to communicate with them. And you ask them the best way of communication, phone call, text, email, mail, whatever they want. But communication is very, very important. What else? We learned from this game. Yes, Afi. Patient and commitment. Brother Dr. Lugubesi, he got impatient and he left. You need to be patient. Sometimes a project needs one year, it takes 10 years. Don't ever give up. Our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he taught us to be patient. Especially in our field. To be patient with your community. Give them a chance. Another chance. A third chance. A fourth chance. Give your brother 70 excuses. And if you don't find any, blame yourself. Give them chances after chances. Never give up. Never give up and leave the game, ya Sheikh Muhammad.
If it is impossible, you can't waste your time.
Then leave it with rules. Brothers, explain to them why you are leaving. So we need to explain ourselves. When you give up, you need to explain yourself before you give up. You cannot just quit on us like this. This is penalty, you have to pay membership for the next 2 years. What else, ikhwan? Tfadal akhi. Plan. If they sit 1 minute before they start this game, 1 minute, and they understand the rules, and they plan it, they will do it. But they did not right away. They are very hyper to start doing it, and they did not make it. Unfortunately, they accused us with one bad thing. Said we are whether execute without planning or planning without executing. And both are wrong. We need to plan, like the Prophet ﷺ did, then execute. But planning without or without doing this and that, it doesn't work. What else we learned from this simple, silly game? Okay, we need to know why we are doing this. Very good. Why we are doing this? Sheikh Omar, I handle you this. We know that it's a game. Why you want us to do this? But they cannot ask because why? Because of this discussion. Jazakallah khair. But in the other projects, we need to know why we are doing this. Why we want all universities to be under one umbrella? Why? This is your goal? Is what? This is your Islam? Yes, it is. When you believe in your goal, you will not, never ever give up. Even if it takes not 18 months, 18 years, you will keep working. Because as Sheikh Al-Ghalayini said in the morning, he said the results is not our hands. We have to do the effort and the result we in Allah's hand. We ask Allah to help us. What else, Akhi? I ask here, Brother Husni, what you say? Appointed the goal. Exactly, to know the rules and what. Yes, sir. Appoint people with knowledge. We'll ask so seven people, they should ask themselves, who is the best among us? He knows what we are going to do. That's a good point. Because sometimes we underestimate people. And they might have knowledge more than we do, and they are in our committee, and we don't know that. We should not ignore and not acknowledge people. What else, Sheikh?
They reach over there without getting permission from their wife.
That's a good one. Sheikh Rahid. Strategy and execute this plan according to our ability and capability. That's good. Yes, Akhi. Dr. Sayyid Abdullah.
I think with communication also different character.
Different?
Different character. We will have different character and the project will be
more difficult.
More difficult.
It's a sword double side. When you have diversity in any committee, that will add beauty or all problems. But most of the time, wallahi, the diversity, it added beauty. Look, Salman, radiallahu anhu, from where? Persia. Khalid, radiallahu anhu. From where? Suhaib, from where? Al-Rumi. All those together, what they did? A great, wonderful job. Diversity should add beauty, not the opposite. We have to take advantage of the community we live in. Diversity, it is the most important, strong tools in our hand. Because in one meeting, you got the whole experience from Pakistan, the whole experience from Bangladesh, from India, from Egypt, from Jordan, from Sudan, everyone around the table. Others, they don't have this thing. So we have these tools. We have to take advantage of the diversity and make it to our credit. Yes, Sheikh? Yes, sir.
If they know their reward, if they can finish, or their punishment.
Thank you very much. He said punishment from the wife. Yes, to know the reward. When you know your goal, how much you will be rewarded by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then you will believe in it and you will work for it. When you believe in having one university instead of 10 small ones, and each one barely can survive. When we have one strong, accredited, strong university with the same curriculum, produce for us qualified imams to unite the ummah in one school of thought, in one fikr. I don't mean one school of thought, yani just one madhab. No, I mean fikr. Because just the university who transfer the manhaj to others, to fikr the others. The first things the Jew did when they came to this country, they built a university in Manhattan. First thing, before they built temples. Why? Because they know the university, what it can do. No Islamic centers, nobody can do it. University. For this, when you believe in your goal, make it easy on you, and you know the reward you will get by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. What else, Ikhwani? Do we have anything else? Yes. Just one point I would like to hear it from you. I don't want to say it. Listen and follow up with the seerah. Jazakallah khair. With the? Sincerity. I thought seerah to Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Yes, listen and follow up. If we assign a leader, follow up. Follow with him. Whatever he said, do it. You will get two rewards. First of all, the reward for doing be part of this job. Second, the sunnah of following your imam or obeying your imam, because Allah will reward you for two. What else, Ikhwani? Imam Basir. So you asking the community to look at positive way to the committees?
Yeah, the way they, the when any committee hold a project, they have to do it the way that bring the fun and the love and the enjoy to the community share with them.
Jazakallah khair. This is a very important point. I will emphasize on it after hearing the point I would like to hear. Yes, sir. Imam Harun. Jazakallah khair. Brother Adel, he's trying his best to do that. Tell them, we should do this, we should that. We need to diagnose our problem. We should not solve it each one in his way. I diagnose the problem first. Diagnose the problem. Yes, sir. The leader also, they should listen to him and he should listen to others. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam used to ask everyone, those people around him, what shall we do in this? Even he is the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and Allah revealed to him, he want to teach us how to do things, asking and counseling with others, share with others. Yes, Afi, I will come there. We can like copycat or make the similar of other people, follow other people. We should not, yani, the wheel, what is it?
Invent the wheel.
Yeah, invent the wheel from scratch or start from. Let us learn from others. That's good. If we know that other people, other group, they have the same, similar project, let's ask them what you did. Learn from them, take whatever good, leave whatever is what bad. Yes, Akhi Huna, we give the chance.
Don't put down anyone's.
Jazakallah khair. That's the point I want. Funny, their problem, this is the main problem. While they are trying to get this down, they are pointing fingers. Everyone, he is accusing the others that this is your fault. Ya Akhi, go up. Ya Akhi, go down. Akhi, stop. Point fingers and criticize others. If each one of us emphasizes on his job, we'll do it. But what they did, each one of them started blaming who? Others, and he forgot what?
You are the one who told us to do this.
I told you to do this, you did not listen. So we need to follow and stop criticizing others. Ikhwani, what happened in this game? It's a silly game, simple one. But see how many lessons we learn? Ikhwani, each one of them, when he starts criticizing others, he forgot what? To watch his fingers. He forgot to watch himself. That's why, the minute, for example, Dr. Ghubeshi starts talking to Brother Adil, I watch Brother Muhammad Al-Ghubeshi fingers and he misses it. That's the way I track them. Ikhwani, the minute you start to criticize others and look at other people's mistakes and sin, you forget what? And who did this? The shaitan. He starts watching and who is not going to make the sujood Iblis alayhi min Allahi al-la'na. He forgot himself. So we need to remember ourselves first before point fingers and criticize others. Yes, sir. Allah yiftah aliyah. When you do this, the brother, ya akhi, you are not doing this. He forgot that three fingers point at your side. Dr. Ahmed. الله يفتح عليه. ما شاء الله. Beautiful. We need to acknowledge what we are doing. When we believe that what we are doing is great, we should take it serious and plan for it, implement it right, do it right, assign the big tasks for each one of us, assign leader. But when we think that what we are doing is silly, like this game, okay, doesn't matter. He can give up and go back to his place. Yes, Dr. Muhammad. Last point from the Sheikh here.
Document your process.
Thank you very much. We need to document our process. Of course, in this silly game, no. But in Project Akhi, because all our rules, we remember it only. Is there a akhi? Did we write this? Did we take this decision? Ya akhi, you remember? Kunna, after we did breakfast, we have our breakfast, we discuss it and we decide. After, it doesn't work this way. It doesn't work. You need to document everything you do. That's if you want to accomplish your project and get it done. Sheikh Ra'ad Bin, we have another things to learn.
We need to fix it one more time.
We need to do it one more time. Inshallah. In the end of the conference, I will give you the same task.
No.
No, because there is more exercises to learning. Just a question now. Yes, we will do that, inshallah ta'ala. Review, ikhwan. Review. First point. Criticize akhi, guide people and share with them your ideas without point fingers, without put them down, without the humiliation. Exactly. We'll talk about this now, inshallah, in the second exercise. First point, now review. Review, review. Number one. Team number. Number two. Leadership. Number three. Rules. Number four, abilities, capabilities. Number five, understand the goals, the reward, and all these things. Number six, communication. Number seven, documentation. Number eight, plan and strategy. Number nine, patience. This is very important. Number 10, evaluation. Jazakallah. Who said evaluation? You said, wallah, I thought from this direction. Dr. Muhammad Hassan, evaluation. Jazakumullah khair. Ikhwani, now I want you to ask questions. This silly game we made, did we learn a lot from it? Yes? Can we change our methodology in the masajid? instead of sitting and wearing this abaya and sit behind the chair with my full respect and start, do this for your youth. Attract them to attend your halaqa. If you do this, they will come before others. But if you keep just lecturing them and say, okay, Sheikh, I have Sheikh Google. I stop him whenever I want. And he will play whenever I want. But when you bring in new ideas, I said, no, Sheikh Google cannot do this for me. Now you have a competition with Sheikh Google. Wallahi, Afwan. They said, we have our Sheikh 24 hours in our smartphone. Anytime I want to listen, I play this Sheikh. Different Sheikh, different Imams from all over the world. When I want to stop, I don't ask him, excuse me, I want to please. No, just boom. And be quiet. Yes or no? So you have a big competition, Afwan. If you don't use a new methodology, you will lose your audience. You will lose the youth, especially the youth. Jazakumullah khair. There is another exercise. How much time we have? Okay. Another exercise we have. I need a new 10 volunteer. 10. Yalla, khawan. And I want you to learn a lot from this because that's what concerns us as an imam. 10 volunteers, please. على الساحة هون. تفضلوا أخي. Huh? Scared? No, don't be scared. Why scared? You will see now. Okay, halaqa, please circle, and put your hands together. Close the circle. More. I need two more. Sheikh Safwa, تفضل.
Which way you want the hand to be like this?
Just one more. It doesn't matter. The way you want. Yes, you want to teach them now the dance. Sheikh Safwa, تعال اثنين. الشيخ حكم عملي ده بعد الشيخ الجلسة كلها. Okay, it's easy. Come forward. والله خلي وراك 2 foot free. أيوة. إخواني, it's easy. Now, when I said in, you come 1 foot in. In, come 1 foot in. Out, you go 1 foot out. Right, you go 1 foot right. Left, you go 1 foot left. Is it easy? Easy? Now, follow what I'm saying. And say it. Follow me and say it. But say it. Okay. If I said in, you go in. Out, out. Left, left, right, right. Okay, follow me and say it. And what? Say it. Okay. In, out, left, right, in, out, left, right. Okay, now, good training. Now say it, but a little bit quickly. In, out, left, right. One more time. In, out, left, right. Thank you. Now, say what I said and do the opposite. Say what I said and do the opposite. If I, hold on. If I say in, you said in, but you do what?
Out.
So say what I said and do the opposite. Clear? In, out, left, right. One more time. Give you another chance. It's easy, Juan. Listen, you have to say what I said and do the opposite.
Out, in, right, left.
Out, in, right.
You fail. One more time. One more time. Ahi, say what I said and do the opposite. It's easy. Out, in, right, left.
Out, in, right, left.
هذا لما يجي الثالثة say the opposite and do what I said. Oh my God. Now I want you to say they fail, by the way. Big time. Now say the opposite and do what I said.
Okay.
If I said in, out, you said out, in. Left, right, you say right, left. But do the what I said. Say the opposite and do, say the opposite. مخالفة الخطوة. طيب. In, out, right, left. Say the opposite and do what I said. Just say what the opposite. But do what I asked you to do. In, out, right, left.
Out, in, left,
right. Jazakumullah khair. Thank you. Jazakumullah khair. They failed big time. What we learned from this silly game? Yes, sir. You need to know the right direction, rules, direction, direction, direction. Study, do your homework before you do anything. If you want to build a masjid, go and research how many masjid around us, how many miles far from us. Everything, budget, everything. Learn. What else?
You have to get the action to work with the limbs.
Work with the?
With the foundation. What you need to have.
Very good. Thank you. Direction special from the leader.
Just
whatever you say, you should follow. This is in Islam. I appreciate that. But this game is different. But you are right. This is atharul kalima. Okay, this is the effective of the word. You just say it, but you cannot do something else. This is the nature of a human being. Say something and do something else. This is the hypocrisy. That's why hypocrisy is bad, because it's against not Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala words and commands, but it's against nature. You cannot say something and do something else. What else we learn? Yes, doctor. How to receive other people's mistakes and how you solve it. Yes, jazakallah khair, Sheikh Muhammad Musa. This is Shafra or Shifra? Jazakallah khair. But the only person who asked brother, what's your name? Ismail, he's the only brother, he asked me twice. But nobody asked. Ask, Akhi. Yes, sir. Jazakallah khair. As a leader, never ever reach something and do something else. Because you are not ruining your life only, yourself only. You are ruining the community lives. Because they look at you as an example. If you are not practicing what you are preaching, it's a problem. Yes, Athena, Imam Ra'uf al-Zaman, New York, Hafidha Allah.
If the leader makes a mistake, everybody is confused.
Exactly. One of us, very good point. If one of us did mistakes, we got confused, all of us. All of us. So the failure of one means the failure of what? Of all. So when you say, Sheikh Omar, Naif, if you feel that we fail, my failure is yours. Help me to solve this problem. Not just keep slap my face. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. We have to have a leader. Yes, Sheikh Hatim?
We have to have a leader. Yes, Afi.
Russian.
What?
Russian.
To rush to do things, sometimes it takes us to the wrong direction. Before they listen full direction, they start to practice it. You're right. Yes, Afi. We need to understand the capacity of people, the ability and capability. Very good. We give you a chance. Let's go there. Yes, sir.
My opinion is the most important is discipline.
Discipline. Discipline is required in anything. For example, if we have a board member did not attend our meetings for the last 1 year, do we need him? Do we need him? 1 year he did not attend our meeting. He is not interested in what we are doing. So please step out, bring someone else. Yes or no? Yes, Afi, me, Sheikh Tabba.
You cannot be successful from the first time. You need to
try again and never give up. Never give up. Try once, twice, thrice. Keep trying, Afi. Wallahi, if there is will, there is way. If there is will, there is way. Yes, Afi.
Giving instructions that agree with
the... Brother, I cannot hear you. I cannot hear him because of your discussion, please. Jazakumullah kul khair. Relief organization, you are our sponsor, Jazakumullah kul khair, but don't disturb our meeting. You're supposed to support us and cover our deficit, which is $12,700. Yes, Afi. Give guidance according to the nature. Yes, you're right. Because when they say something and do something else, wallahi, this is against the nature. Don't ask people something they cannot do it. Yes, Afi. Allah yiftah alayk. Don't expect that what you do exactly to what your expectation. Sometimes you expect something and you do something else and you end up with something another thing. So all the time, prepare yourself to live with any situation and go forward. Never give up and go back. Yes, sir.
More practicing will achieve the highest level of
writing. More?
Practicing.
More practicing, yes. If they practice more, I know for sure, if they spend 48 hours learning this, they will make it good. But 48 hours, they are. You're right, practice. Yes, Afi. What is that time?
You're asking to do something that you feel or you cannot do it, you can give up or have
to. Jazakallah khul khair. You need to know your ability. What can I do? If I cannot do this project, let me step out. Afi, I cannot do it. Please ask someone else qualified. Has a qualification to do this. Instead of just keep trying and trying, you know that you cannot do it. Maybe somebody else, less qualification, he can do this specific part. The last point, Akhi. Communication. Barakallah fi. Sometimes the imams saying something in the east and the community in the west. For example, this is Amira. We know the suffering of Al-Quds people recently. And the imam, he gave a khutbah about Salatu Al-Mar'a Al-Had. People, they got confused. And they called me, Sheikh Omar, this is the time to talk about this. So sometimes you need to understand what's going on. You need to communicate with people with something they care about, they are interested in. I'm not putting down this matter to do perfect prayer is one of obligation things, but everything has the right time. Everything has the right time. Might this imam has specific issues force him to do that, but we need to understand what our community needs. I will stop right there. We can keep going on and on, learning from what?
very silly game. Yes or no? Please, brothers, respected imams, try to innovate a new methodology in dealing with youth, especially with the youth. A new methodology. Attract them. Get them closer to you. Some people, they said, if I am not in their age or close, it doesn't work. No. No. That's not right. You need to work with them whether you are 60 years old or 30 years old. Because our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam did so. Yes or no?
No.
That's what he did, sallallahu alaihi wasallam. He did treat with others, deal with young, with old people, mashallah, in the same beautiful way. So we can follow his footsteps, sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and treat people. يعني خاطب الناس على قدري أقولهم. We have to address people according to what they understand. Otherwise, it will be a big fault. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to guide us and to make this time beneficial for all of us. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us the patience and make us among those who listen and follow the best all the time. Dear respected imams, bottom line, you have to come up with a new methodologies and ideas in reaching out, especially who they are. My time is over. Inshallah ta'ala, tomorrow we'll get another exercise, but not team building, in communication. Because communication is very important. Before I leave the stage to my beloved Sheikh, I would like to introduce to our gathering the FBI, the second person FBI in charge in Chicago, Brian. He is with us here. He wants to convey a message for you for 5 minutes. He is not like imams. We say 5 minutes, he strict with 5 minutes. Because they said, don't ever give a mic to a Sheikh or a phone to a woman because they want to stop. But I'm sure that when he says 5 minutes, 5 minutes. So Mr. Brian, he's the second person in charge of the FBI in Chicago. Every conference we make, we contact the authority, FBI, city mayor, police department, in order to inform them of what we are doing. So they be aware, and in the same time, they work and they do their job in securing this beautiful gathering. Now I will let you with Mr. Brian.
Thank you very much. I appreciate the introduction and Dr. Shaheen and other distinguished members of the board and guests. I really appreciate the opportunity. And as I walked in, it kind of reminded me of I had just been to my own religious services last week, and there was a large gathering of religious leaders, and they were talking about things, and the priest, I'm a Catholic, said, you know, I've got good news and bad news. And so the good news is we have all the money we need here in this room to make sure that we can build a new church, give alms to the poor, etc. And I was, well, that's really good. Well, the bad news is it's all in your pockets. So I only say that because I know your job is very challenging and you have a lot on your agenda, and I saw it, and I know that you have a very busy schedule, so I will stick to the 5 minutes. What I'd like to say is that we really appreciate this opportunity because as law enforcement officers, we look to partner with a number of different community leaders, whether they're religious leaders, civic leaders, what have you. It's very, very important for all of the American society that we have that good dialogue back and forth. There's a substantial number of areas that here in the Chicago area that we try to partner with our community leaders, whether they're Muslim leaders, other faiths and various groups. And from that, we think we've made a good effort to counter some things here local to us, such as gangs, which is a major problem here, internet fraud crimes, things such as human trafficking, which probably touches some of your communities, civil liberty issues, civil rights issues, things in that nature. And also, we work on what we call countering violent extremism, which is a White House mandate to basically go out and move beyond dialogue, which is extremely important, and really set up apparatus and venues to work on specific cases, whether that is terrorism related to the Islamic tradition or terrorism related to white supremacy or other domestic groups out here. So it's not specific to any one group. But we think here that we've got a good way to do that. And so I will just conclude by saying, I really encourage you to get in touch with your local FBI office if you haven't done that, and do what I'm asking, which is move beyond the dialogue. That is extremely important, but really get down behind the scenes, if you will, and look to partner in ways, whether that's just one person that we're working collaboratively on as a community to save and pull back from whatever their wrong path is, or a broader goal. So here we like to just look at the individuals. Our ambitions are big, but we start by each and every person, and we really have a good relationship here with the Islamic community here, at least many parts of it, and we're always wanting to broaden that. But we think we've got a good model, and I'm happy to talk more about it with people in the room afterward. They'll stay around for a few minutes. But I really appreciate the opportunity, and again, I look at your agenda. I know you're very, very full. I only had one request of the doctor that I'm allowed to speak before lunch and not after. So I really appreciate that. Thank you very much and have a blessed day.
Thank you. Thank you very much, Mr. Prime. Just I want to add something that Dr. Shaheen yesterday told me, that wherever they go, they send the letters, the invitation to the FBI, but they did not respond. Here in Chicago, they respond, and we thank them. And to tell you guys, Chicago tried to be the best, okay? Unless the weather. Just be enjoying Chicago. And we told them that we have a convention here, and they check the area around us here to make everything safe and to secure us. Thank you very much. And ma'ana break, inshallah. التاج يا اخوه بتاخذوها وانتم طالعين كل واحد ياخذ اسمه عشان نعرف بعض الله يبارك فيكم نرجع ان شاء الله بعد 15 دقيقه